orange losses, but facing cloud today, the Rush defense could also be a source of concern. Another source of concern, Quentin Spotwood, their outstanding wide receiver and punt returner, suffered a knee injury in the Cincinnati game, and he will not play this afternoon for the Orangemen at that game at Boston College. When we come back, we'll check out the national scene. Looking ahead to our national notebook, spotlight some big upcoming games like the Oregon Ducks against UCLA and the unique story of a Pittsburgh wide receiver when we come back.
The University of Pittsburgh. University of Pittsburgh. From here, you can see the world.
Here's the score. You've been bitten by a vampire.
In the war against evil.
You're gonna help us fight him.
They must do all they can.
He's near.
To keep the enemy.
Time to kill some vampires.
From a new battlefield.
Open wide, baby.
You can't kill me.
James Woods, John Carpenter's Vampires, rated R. Opens everywhere October 30th.
You read Barron's?
Oh, yeah. All the time. That's the one where they raid all the online brokers. I use Discover Brokerage. They've been Barron's top pick for, like, the last 3 years.
You invest online?
Oh, yeah. Big time. Well, the last few years anyway. I'm retired now.
You're retired?
Oh, I don't need to do this. I just, you know, like helping people.
Vacation spot?
Actually, it's a picture of my house.
That's an island.
Well, technically it's a country. Weird thing about owning your own country, though. You gotta name it.
Imagine TV.
Today, Mercury announced a factory-authorized year-end clearance. Translation, save big.
Here's your last chance to get your best year-end deal on a 98 Mercury Mountaineer with V8 power and all-wheel drive. Plus, improve your cash flow with low 2.9% financing for up to 48 months.
Bottom line.
Bottom line, save over $4,800 in finance charges over and above your best clearance deal on a Mercury Mountaineer, just in time for winter. Imagine yourself in a Mercury.
Welcome back to the National Car Rental Halftime Report, brought to you by National Car Rental. So what are you waiting for? Let's go! And at halftime on homecoming, it is hail to Pitt, because they have a 21-7 lead over the Scarlet Knights. We've updated you on what's going on in the Big East this afternoon. Let's check out some national scores. Number one team in the country is playing this afternoon, the Buckeyes of Ohio State, pounding Minnesota 31-3 in the second quarter. Wisconsin shutting out Illinois. That game is at halftime. Continuing our ESPN USA Today top 25, Georgia shutting out Vandy 24-0 second quarter. South Carolina ahead of Arkansas right now. The Razorbacks trailing in the second quarter of that matchup. No score in the first quarter. Texas Tech and Colorado. There are other big national games, especially out west. That brings us to today's edition of the National Notebook. Here is Mike Gleason.
Some spectacular performances around the country last weekend. For starters, how about Drew Brees of Purdue? 83. That's right, 83 pass attempts against Wisconsin, a new NCAA record. He completed 55 of the 83, which tied another record. Meanwhile, Ricky Williams continues his march for the Heisman. He now ranks third on the all-time yardage list after his 139-yard performance against Oklahoma. Now, week to week, we talk about the top matchups and the top players across the nation. Well, this week, let's switch gears and talk about a couple of players who don't quite get the pub, even though they're among the nation's leaders. Today, Missouri hosts Oklahoma. Leading the Tigers is tailback Devin West, who compiled 252 yards and 40 carries last Saturday and continues to rank second nationally with 192 yards an outing. With all the talented quarterbacks in the Pac-10, one guy who has truly shined is Oregon quarterback Akili Smith. Today, he leads the 11th-ranked Ducks against number 2 UCLA. Smith has led his team to a 51 points per game average while leading the entire country in passing efficiency. I'm Mike Gleason with this week's National Notebook.
All right, Mike, thank you very much. We will continue now with the National Car Rental Halftime Report. And coming up, it is our Big East feature, and we're going to look at Kenny Ketchen. It's been a long and winding road that brought him here to the University of Pittsburgh. That is coming up when we return right after this. Stay with us, back in a minute.
Well, he's a hard worker, you know. He spends a lot of time, you know, when we're at our house on the farm, you know, he spends a lot of long hours. And from that and from his dedication to the sports when he was a coach, he spent a lot of hours in that, and he spent a lot of time with the players. And he's a very friendly person. Everybody in the town knows him, says hi. The biggest thing I took from him was that he cares, and then he's a hard worker. Dad, thanks for everything. It's been great.
At National, we always thought of ourselves as the top car rental company, and now we're glad to see that our customers agree. See, according to a J.D. Power & Associates study, National's just been ranked the highest car rental company in customer satisfaction in a tie. Thanks. We couldn't have done it without you.
How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is.
Let's go.
They're the sheep, and we are the shepherds. We tell them that college is the doorway. We tell them to prepare for the future. But the question remains, will we?
New York is a city of excess. Why one trade tower when you can have two? Why just one Broadway? Why 9 to 5 when New York never sleeps? And like New York, Delta Airlines offers you more. Like the most non-stops to more cities in Europe, as well as service from all 5 airports. And as for getting to them, why one bridge when you can have 18? Delta Airlines, putting you on top of the world.
We think an SUV should be less status symbol and more truck. So you'll find a truck-based steel frame under every Jimny to give it backbone and make it as solid and true as a GMC truck.
Buy a 98 Jimny during the 98 sell-down and get this solid deal. $2,000 cash back or 0.9% APR financing. It's just one of the many values at your GMC dealer today.
Jimny by GMC.
From Pittsburgh, we continue now with the National Car Rental Halftime Report, brought to you by National Car Rental. What are you waiting for? Let's go. It's 21-7 as we begin to wind down halftime. Pitt Panthers have the lead. You know, at the start of the season, the quarterback at Florida State, Chris Wendke, got a lot of attention because he was coming back as a 26-year-old. Now, the Pitt Panthers have a 26-year-old of their own. We've seen a bit of him here in the first half. He's the subject of our Big East feature.
For some athletes, playing college football is a stepping stone to the NFL. For University of Pittsburgh wide receiver Kenny Ketchen, football is a way to better himself and receive a free education. After playing baseball and basketball at Mount Vernon High in New York, Ketchen struggled to find his place in society. But then his grandfather suggested he try the military.
He said, man, it's time for you to get your life together because you wasn't really doing anything in high school. These streets in New York will swallow you up, you know, if you don't have a goal or a focus in life. You know, saying, go ahead, go to the military, grow up a little bit, see the world, and, you know, find out what you want to do with your life.
After joining the Navy, Kenny was based aboard the USS Independence in Kitty Hawk as an operations specialist. And after the Persian Gulf War broke out, Ketchen found himself perilously close to the center of conflict.
It made me value family. It made me want more out of myself. I didn't just want to go out there and be lackadaisical and just go through the motions. I wanted to do something with myself.
When the conflict came to an end, Kenny turned his attention to the gridiron while at Chaffee College in Rancho Cucamonga, California. During his sophomore season, Ketchen became a star receiver and began attracting attention from Division I programs. On the way, he broke the school record for receiving yards in a game, 202.
So we kept our eye on him, and finding that he was from New York, California Junior College prospect from the East Coast, it was a nice mix. So we proceeded the recruiting part of it, and you know, found more about Kenny and his Gulf War stories, and really interesting, a lot of leadership qualities, good hard worker, and you know, one thing led to another, and we offered him a scholarship and got him here.
After finishing his outstanding career at Chaffee, Kenny's dreams of playing big-time college football here at Pittsburgh were actually put on hold due to unfinished business.
Like 22 units, and that's like maybe 7 or 8 classes.
We've been burnt by some guys that don't really care much about doing all the little things and dotting all the I's and crossing all the T's. And being around Kenny, we felt like he would be the right kind of guy.
I was like, well, it's not going to happen with me because I'm going for it. This is right here. It's on the table. I'm about to get it.
Kenny finished the classes, and although he struggled in his brief career at Pittsburgh, his attitude remains positive.
I mean, it's a bunch of little cliches and words that you can say, but if you want it bad enough, you'll pay the dues to get it. It's not going to come overnight.
Ketchen has experienced the combat of war and the collisions of big-time college football and sees many likenesses between the two.
First, you go through the little your SOE in the military, like your schedule of events. Then you have your little play sheet here. You got to strategize what you want to do, get it precise, go through with your troops, you know, how you want to go ahead and attack this, go through with our players, hit the meeting. There's so many similarities. I didn't know football. You had to go through so much, you know, before you played the game.
Because of his attitude and experience, Ketchen is a great representative for the University of Pittsburgh.
And the fact that he wants to graduate and get it done so that he can have a better life, I think that's really admirable, and I know it sends the right message to the rest of our team.
It's tough times everywhere you go. Tough times just growing up. The streets, life can just be tough without even going to war. Everybody, like, every person has their little time in their life that they go through it, you know, but it's how you pick up and finish it. That's the whole thing.
He's going to finish up here with a degree in sociology, wants to be a teacher, maybe a social worker, and anyhow, he will influence in a positive way young people. Our next influence will come from Dave and Jeff as they bring you the first half highlights and stats on the National Car Rental Halftime Report.
That's the biggest moment. My mom really pushed graduation. You know, when you grow up, they always have dreams. My mom wanted me to be an astronaut or something. But I can't explain the emotional aspect of it, but just the physical part, it's going to be a relief. I did it, accomplished my goals. That's the day I look forward to more than anything. Actually, I call my mom Blackbird, so thanks, Blackbird, for all the confidence you had in me, and thanks, Pops, for installing the hard work and the values.
Accept it. The college football game you want to see isn't on where you live, and there's nothing you can do about it. Or is there? Imagine a place where the games you want to see are on every Saturday. A place where you can see up to 100 college matchups this season. Just order ESPN Game Plan, ESPN's pay-per-view college football package, and we'll bring you more of the best games from top schools and conferences. And all in your own backyard. ESPN Game Plan. To order, call DirecTV, PrimeStar, Dish Network, or your cable company.
Work piling up?
Let's go!
That's the perfect time to declare a national holiday.
Let's go!
National Car Rental's declaring every day a national holiday.
Let's go!
For the great holiday rates, you can escape to the outdoors.
Let's go!
Or the golf greens.
Let's
or
go.
The tropical beaches.
Let's go!
So call National Car Rental now.
Let's go!
And declare your own national holiday.
Let's
what are you
go.
Waiting for? Let's go!
Dressing up for Halloween can be really neat. Now ABC7 has some tips to make sure it's a treat. When you're walking at night, wear something bright. If cars can't see you, there could be a boo-boo. If you're out of sight, you give drivers a fright. So on trick-or-treat night, take along a flashlight. ABC7 and your Tri-State Quality 4 dealers wish you a happy Halloween. For more safety tips, pick up your Halloween bag and coupon book at participating Burger King restaurants.
I'm Peter Vallone. I think it's time someone stood up for President Clinton and stood up to all the Republicans who are trying to tear him down. I don't understand why they want to destroy a man who's done so much for New York, from Head Start to health care, from college grants to economic development. Now Al D'Amato, George Pataki, and the Republican Party are determined to bring the president down, even if it means hurting our country. Censure the president if necessary, then forgive him and move on, for the good in our hearts and for the good of our country.
It's being brought to you by John Hancock Financial Services. Insurance for the unexpected, investments for the opportunities. Welcome back to Pittsburgh, everybody. Panthers 21-7 lead over Rutgers. Dave Sims and Jeff Bostic with you. And time to look at our first half highlights brought to you by the good folks at John Hancock. And things are looking pretty good here for Rutgers when the bounce went their way. Reggie Stevens, look at these bounces. You kidding?
Look like basketball 57 yards later. Rutgers is on the board leading this game 7-0.
Then into the second quarter, Kevin Barlow. Easy run right here. Hammers it home. That tied it at 7, ending a 69-yard drive.
Matt Lytle, the fifth-year senior quarterback. Glad to see number 81, Terry Murphy, back in the lineup. He scores a touchdown.
That was a 58-yard drive that took 2 minutes and 58 seconds, and then real easy for Latif Grimm.
Giving the Pittsburgh offense a 21-7 lead. And the big thing is Barlow has been impressive running the football. Matt Lytle has been sharp after the game got going. They struggled early, but came back the poise of a fifth-year senior.
16 carries, 93 yards for Barlow. And a kickoff out of bounds. Nick Lotz knocked it out of bounds, so Rutgers will have a good field position for a change.
We talk about unexcusable. The kicker has a field that's 54 yards wide. Just kick it somewhere between those 54 yards, please.
Free kick, out of bounds, by the kicking team.
So the Scarlet Knights get the ball at the 35-yard line. Here we go. Scarlet Knights need some plays to go to their way, and they make one right here. Here's a big one inside the 30-yard line to the tight end, Chris Hutton. And that was as wide open as any receiver has been all afternoon for Rutgers.
You have to wonder what went on in the Rutgers locker room at halftime. Terry Shea, he would have to have held court. We look at the halftime statistics. The one that jumps out, look at the total yards, 299 to 59. The only thing that kept this game close, turnovers.
Sacks, 3 of them by Pittsburgh, 1 by Rutgers. 30-yard gain to Hutton. Nick, check that, a 40-yard gain to Hutton. Big gain and run a counter Trey. It goes nowhere. It's busted up nicely by Phil Clark. He was there first. And then Amir Purifoy was there to finish it off, number 19. Leaders in the first 30 minutes of play. Very impressive performances by Messrs. Barlow, Lytle, and Murphy. Hot day here at Pittsburgh. Temperatures in the 70s. It's the deepest penetration Rutgers has had all afternoon. Jason O'Heen fighting his way close to the 20-yard line. Purifoy there, number 19 for Pittsburgh.
Jason O'Heen on the carry.
Purifoy on the 21-7, the Pittsburgh lead over Rutgers. This is Big East football. Scarlet Knights and the Panthers here at Pitt Stadium. I'm Dave Sims with Jeff Bostic and John Sanders. First time Rutgers has been in Pittsburgh territory, courtesy of a 40-yard pass from Mike McMahon to Chris Hutton. Another third down situation from the backside. And no flag. There's the flag, a late flag by the official. We saw McMahon pleading a case saying he did have an intended receiver. See what we have. Legal man downfield. So Sean O'Hara. Terry Shea. Had that big 40-yarder to Hutton. It was Hutton's 11th catch of the season, first of the day. And now yet another penalty against the Scarlet Knights. We'll talk it over with Phil Clark.
Illegal touching.
by the offense. The ball first hit an ineligible receiver. The penalty is declined. Fourth down.
So fourth down coming up for Rutgers. And I just want to correct a mistake I made. Hutton, three catches, 57 yards for today.
And they call this illegal touching. The football has to be able to be touched first by someone that's a receiver, tight end, or running back. Sean O'Hara, the left tackle.
I'd hit him in the foot as he was getting up.
Self-defense.
Steve Barone is going to tee it up for a 39-yard field goal attempt. He's one of three on the season, a 28-yarder a couple of weeks ago against Miami. Mike Jones, high snap. Nice job to get it. Barone, but the kick is good. Nice job by the holder, Mike Jones, the junior quarterback. And Barone bangs it through from 39 yards to get Rutgers on the board here in the second half. The snapper, Sean O'Hara. Sean caught a lot of that one. But Jonesy bailed him out. 13:04 to go, third period. And Steve Barone is tacked on three, and Rutgers trails 21-10.
Someday there will be no subways or corporate ladders to climb. If retirement is a bridge to be crossed when we get there, then we must accept whatever lies ahead of us. If it is one we must build, then let us begin.
Since Dodge Caravan's easy-out roller seats have wheels that pop down, reconfiguring the interior is an exercise in convenience. Not an exercise, in exercise. Why don't all the other guys make it this easy? Go configure. Caravan, the new Dodge.
When sports cream? When legs are sore, when backs ache, when muscles hurt. Why sports cream? Rubbing it in brings fast pain relief. No medicine-y smell. Why sports cream? Because it works.
This year, over 400,000 aluminum radiators will corrode and fail. But Prestone antifreeze bonds with aluminum, forming the Prestone zone of protection against corrosion. It's your car. Protect it in the Prestone zone.
Special teams indeed, and give a lot of credit to Mike Jones, the backup quarterback, with a great save here.
You know what? Right here's Mike Jones's hand. Snap the ball there, Sean O'Hara. Watch this left knee. Watch his left knee. How high is that snap? His left leg collapses. A holder can make a kicker and a snapper look good. Kudos to Mike Jones. Great job of holding.
Number 25, Lee McDonald will.
Mike started three games last year, first three games of the 97 season, before giving way to Mike McMahon. Lee McDonald has it teed up, and we're going to be ready for action. First time for the Panthers getting the ball here in the second half at Pitt Stadium. Don't want Poteet to catch it, that's for sure, and they're going to fall on it right there. Ryan Gonzalez, number 55, the backup linebacker, recovered for Pittsburgh. So the field position, not great, but could have been worse. It's at the 26-yard line.
And the big key for Rutgers, you know, your offense finally puts points on the board this afternoon. It wasn't a touchdown. McMahon throws a strike to Chris Hutton, sets up the field goal. Now we see if their defense can feed off that momentum.
And they certainly could use it. 21-10 is not outrageous by any stretch of the imagination. It's just that you've got to give a lot of credit to the Rutgers defense for keeping it this close. Barlow, nowhere to go. Maybe a gain of one. Strung out nicely. Mike Bell was there, number 94.
Kevin Barlow carries.
Barlow is hurting his left knee as he's coming out of the football game. Limping on that left knee again. This is the third time he's left the game.
They go with Isaac Williams as the tailback now. Second down and nine.
Lytle throws to the back. They like that play. This time the pass is complete to Williams across the 30 to the 32. And Reggie Stevens, number 9, brings him down.
And these are the situations that, you know, Dennis Crean, the defensive coordinator for Rutgers, he wanted coming into this game. You said it, Dave. They like this little swing pass. Williams catches the ball, picks up a few yards. Once again, Pittsburgh's offense is faced with a 3rd and 6. Does Rutgers commit to blitzing and trying to put pressure on Lytle?
See, if they don't blitz this time, as Crean takes a look at it. Williams, swing pass right side, and boy, he's going to be close. Heck of an effort by Isaac Williams. Played his junior college ball at Pasadena City College. Reggie Stevens again on the stop. This is going to be close.
Senior linebacker number 49, Dak Strohmeyer, had the opportunity to force Pittsburgh to punt the football. Misses a tackle in the open field.
5-yard gain, so they did get the first down. First down, Pittsburgh. Ball's at the 37. Barlow getting that left ankle worked on. Right, a little play action. Got time. Had time. He's going to take it down and run. He gets out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Chased out of bounds by Marcus Perry, number 59 of Rutgers.
And as we saw Kevin Barlow on the sideline, the one thing that is true, when you're playing on AstroTurf and you have an ankle or a knee that's bothering you, this is the wrong stuff to be playing on.
Stuff's hard.
You know what? The thing that is underneath this carpeting is asphalt.
That's comforting.
Put a little bit of pad under it and roll some carpet on it. That's what we have here.
Lytle, 5 rushing attempts, 38 yards. Second and long, Isaac Williams pushing up to the 45. It'll be short of a first down by about a yard or two. Aaron Brady brings it down. How about Isaac Williams? Pasadena City College, for some of you, that may not ring a bell, but for some of you old-timers and for some of you baseball players, that's where Jackie Robinson played his intercollegiate football before moving on to UCLA. And Isaac scored 16 touchdowns at Pasadena City College. That's the most since Mr. Robinson back in the 40s. It's a pretty
I thought Pasadena was just for the Rose Bowl. Is that
no, sir. Matt, you know, it's funny. The other day in New York, I was at Grand Central Station. I ran into Mrs. Jackie Robinson, who's about 75 years old, looks about 50. She is a great lady. 3rd down and 2. And nice play from behind. Mike Bell getting the job done.
Williams again on the carry.
And that's going to bring up a punt situation for Pittsburgh. Aaron Brady and the boys have forced a punt.
Mike Bell fights off the block.
No gain on the play.
Jeff McCurley, number 11. Aaron Brady skating down the line. The big key thing, Mike Bell, number 94, he loses his shoe and still makes the tackle.
Here's DeBolt. Head time and pretty good punt. Had good hang time. I thought it was going a little bit farther, to be honest with you. It goes out of bounds at the 24, so Rutgers in decent field position. When we come back, that punt covering 37 yards. 9:51 to go, 3rd quarter. Panthers lead at 21-10.
When you ship with Priority Mail, it's a great way to save money. But what about other parts of the world? There's Global Priority Mail. And here's the best part. Give us a few days more, and you can save up to 70% over FedEx or UPS. So, what's your global priority? Try Global Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
We never thought we'd use OnStar for snakes.
I just hate snakes.
Yeah, traveling through Arizona, we blew a front tire, shot off the road, and I looked down at the ground. It is crawling with rattlesnakes.
It was unbelievable.
I pushed the OnStar button. Within seconds, the OnStar advisor pinpointed our location and sent a tow truck.
Called the paramedics.
Yeah, and kept talking because we
hate snakes.
Yeah.
Now, get the OnStar system and installation at no extra charge when you sign up for a year of service. Call 1-888-ONSTAR-7.
You know, being raised here in New York, I know people appreciate style. So if you're going to open a men's store here, You got to know what's what. At the Men's Warehouse, you'll find many of the same brands as department stores, but for 20 to 30%.